Good evening. Welcome to the LRSM's Science Cafe, our last Science Cafe of the semester. This evening, first of all, let me say the LRSM is the Materials Research Lab at the University of Pennsylvania, and these Science Cafes are part of our educational outreach program to the general public, where we try to bring topics of interest related to materials. And our talk tonight certainly falls in that category because it will be about liquid crystals. We're fortunate in having some visitors from the University of Ljubljana in Slovenia who are here for a week to spend time with us. They are from the Department of Education at the university, and they're going to give a talk with some demos on liquid crystals and other anisotropic materials. Our friends from every day. The person in charge of the group is Professor Mojca Čepić, with her graduate students Janija Pavlin and Maja Pichar. So let me hand over to Mojca.
My group is not my group. I call these women their man. My group consists from five people. So there are another two women that remain at home, and they are also doing important business on explaining what anisotropic materials are, what liquid crystals are, and such things. To students, to younger children, to lay public, to anybody who is interested. So what shall we talk about today? This picture is nice and you can make it at home with materials we will provide for you, but let us go further. So first I will make some advertisement for Slovenia. That whenever you come to Europe, that you will consider the possibility to come to Slovenia as well, because Slovenia is a nice country. It's a very tiny one, but still it's nice. So then, we will discuss actually how the LCD screen is working, because we look at LCD screens every day. We have them in iPhones, we have them in iPads, we have them in LCD screens. We look at their films and everything. So, we will try to understand how do we get colors on the screen, how do we get shapes on the screen, and what has to be done that we see these. And at the end, we will make some funny experiments if the time allows. So, well, this part is Slovenia. So we are not a big part of the world. And I don't know, I can't tell in percentages how big we are with respect to the whole world. So even in Europe we are small. So this was former Yugoslavia, but now we are six countries that are separated. But now, look at this, we are big. So we have hills, we have many rivers, we have sea, we have 2 million of inhabitants, which is very little. Our capital city, Ljubljana, has 200,000 people. This is a village for your range of numbers. And we will extinguish in 100 years because our fertility rate is one of the lowest in Europe. So hopefully it will not happen this, but still, you know, if there's a country with its own language and 2 million of people, and in nowadays, it's very high possibility to. Sorry?
Percentage wise, how do you do in the Olympics?
Well, I think in Olympics we were the second per capita.
They were first per capita.
I think we were the second in last Olympics, but usually we are the first. We have the first skier in the world among women. So Tina Maze, she is the world champion. She got how many? 3 globuses, I think. And she was 4,000 points in advantage disrespect to the second one. And she gained something like 2,300 or something like this. The second one was above 1,000 or even below. Well, I'm not following this very. But I think per capita we were the second. But for a time we were the first, yeah. We have something like 3 medals or 4. Per tumina, it's good. Well, let me show you a few pictures. So this is capital. There are famous three bridges. You can sit down here. There are many restaurants. It's very nice. During the summer and also during the winter, we have strong smoking prohibition. So every restaurant has its outer part when you can sit down under the heater and you can enjoy. Then we have the seaside, which is in some places rather wild and in some places rather, I don't know, ordered, if you like. We have some very kitschy places. This is Bled, the famous place where every tourist go. And there are also some remote regions where the nature is really beautiful, but nobody goes there. So now I have first question. Where do we need actually liquid crystals? Liquid crystals are materials that are found in LCD screens. So, let us look that closer. So, let us look first how the liquid, how the screen looks like when we make its magnification. What we will do now, we will check how this screen, you look here, with this picture that is on the screen, is how does it look when it is magnified?
There we go. Okay.
Now, look at this. This is actually a microscope, USB microscope. It is actually a teaching equipment. So you can buy it for something like... Can I tell the price, Randy?
Yes.
It's about 70 euros.
But so it's special tonight if you buy them 150 euros.
So, well, but this is a good magnifier, so you can really play with it. No. And now we can check what the magnification. This is a red color at the screen. Yeah? Wow, that's a red. Okay, now it's really focused and then it's blue. And let us go to magenta, for example. I like magenta the most. So this is magenta, it's only blue and red and all the rest is that. What is white?
So what's the scale? I mean, so
Well, this is the pixel.
Yeah.
This is the smallest part of the screen. And it depends. If you have a good one, then it is small. If you have a bad one, then it is big. And when you have a bad one, it is like part of millimeters. If it is a good one, it is less parts of millimeters. So it's really... Okay. So this is it. And shall we go to some general place? Let's say here. Now, the picture is made from this, in the sense that some of the colors here are brighter and smaller. So if you have something darker, then this is darker. If you have something brighter, these parts of the screen are brighter. Okay. Now we can. So, this is only what we have seen, but we can do a color map out of it. So, if we switch on green and red at the same time, we get yellow. Or we can, if we switch on green and blue, we get cyan. If we switch on all of them, we get white. Can you imagine which part of the picture is this, of this picture? Do you have any idea?
Magenta.
Yeah? Sam?
Magenta.
What I can see is it appears to be rotated.
What?
It appears to be rotated. So I can't.
So I thought that it should be magenta. This part should be magenta. So where it is? Yeah, exactly, lower left corner. Lower left corner of this picture is this part, enlarged. So there is some strange dark parts, and then there is magenta, which is clean. So we would like to know how the pixel is working. The pixel is consists of three parts, red, green, and blue. And what we have to do that we get the picture is that we have to manipulate somehow the brightness of this ring. So we have to be able to switch it off, to switch it on, to make it bright, to make it dark. So now the story of this evening will be how the pixel is working. So with this we do this. So this is white, we have all of them on. For this we have red, then only red part of the pixel is on. So if you ever have the possibility to have some, but you will always have this possibility to have some corrupted PC, take it apart. There are several very funny things inside, and you can make several experiments with them. Okay, write me an email, I can tell you, I can send you some articles about them made by my colleagues. There are several interesting experiments with these parts, but we will work on this. This is the screen. This is the electronics of the screen, and here there are pixels hidden. So the pixel looks like this. This is stolen from Isaac Murray, the factory of liquid crystals, and the producer of liquid crystals. So here you have several things that are found in the pixel, and we will go one after another that is necessary that the pixel is operating. So if we look this, here the red light goes through, the green light is partly absorbed, the blue doesn't. The color is orange. So first we will make a little bit, we will talk a little bit more about liquid crystals. Liquid crystals are special materials. Usually we have water that melts at 0 degrees or 32 Fahrenheit, have I remembered correctly, yeah? And then it's water. So this is our house in Slovenia, we have, this is usual, at least once in a year, but this year was terrible, we had it several times up to the first level. Okay, for your, in your transcription is second level of the height of the snow. So there is a difference. Liquid crystals are materials that have between the crystal, which is this, and, well, there's a mistake, and the liquid, which is this, a liquid crystalline phase. So when you heat the material, it enters to the liquid crystalline phase, which looks like this. This is a crystal, this is a liquid, and in between you have a liquid crystalline phase. On your tables you have now examples of some small capillaries with liquid crystal, which is now in liquid crystalline state. So if you put it in a hot water, here, now I will bring you hot water, if you put it in a hot water, it will melt into this. It will become clear, and we call the temperature that goes from this muddy state to this one a clearing point, a clearing temperature. So this state is something you find in liquid crystalline skin, liquid crystalline screen. So you have to have this state of matter. What is so special with this state of matter? Liquid crystals are formed by elongated molecules. So there have to be molecules that are in one direction longer than in the other. Otherwise, you don't have liquid crystals. So they order in the sense that they have the same direction. So here you have positional ordering and orientational ordering. Here you have this order, this is liquid. And here in between you have the ordered state. And such ordered state has special properties that are typical for a crystal. But on the other hand, because they are liquid, they can also flow. So this is a special material which is very, very easy to manipulate with external forces and fields. There are several liquid crystals. You can find banana faces that are popularly called, that you can have spikes on. But what is important for LCD screens is this. We use only this face in liquid crystals. So, we will, further on, we will work with this. Now, these materials are, due to their order, anisotropic. What does it mean? Let us check this. Can you imagine going, running through the wine? So it is much different if you run in this direction or if you run in this direction. You have to go through the vines and it is much slower. So the property of this, how fast will you be when running through this, will depend on direction you run. So there are several materials that have properties that are direction dependent, that they depend on direction. You apply a force, an external field, or something like this. One of these is really something you know from every day, it's knitting cloth. So if you have your t-shirt, and if you would like to extend your t-shirt in one direction, it would extend differently than the other. So for anisotropy, we have to find something that could be measured. For example, if you have a material that is knitted cloth, we can see such pattern that is usually used for patterns of pullovers extends in one direction for the same weight much, much more than in the other. And it has another property. If you apply the force along the knitting direction or perpendicular to it, it extends in the same way as the force. But if you apply the force in some general direction, it extends in a different direction. These are two properties that are really typical for anisotropic materials. So this is more or less a joke here. Now, to show you that we become to the trade union of theoretical physicists, we have to show you some proper measurements. So these proper measurements are if you apply the field to the force in a general direction, it will move in the different direction than the applied force. And this behavior is exactly the same, that the absorption in wood, which is again an example of an anisotropic material, or as a birefringence or a refraction index in anisotropic optical materials. So let us go to another thing. One of the constituents, so we know now what the disc is, and now another constituent that is found in the screens are polarizers. What are actually polarizers? You have polarizers on your tables, yeah? Yeah. So look at this screen here, through your polarizers. Not this, but this. Or maybe you can look this, it's the same. Huh? Sorry. And then rotate the polarizer.
One is changing.
What is changing?
One is changing, one isn't. No, the big one doesn't change.
No, the big one doesn't change, but this one?
No. I mean, the big screen.
The big screen doesn't change if you rotate and look through? Yeah, what do you find? The big screen doesn't change, but this one? What happens? This medium screen, or the lower one, whatever LCD screen you take, you can take also sometimes, not all of the iPhones. iPhones are not right. If you have a different phone, it might work. So, it's something like this. Yeah. So there is a certain direction where a polarizer doesn't show the picture if you observe through. But there is another. There are other directions where you see that some light is transmitted. So we say that polarizers polarize light, but on the other hand, they transmit the light which is polarized parallel to some certain direction. This is here. The first polarizer polarizes light, the second polarizer allows the light to pass. Here it is different. The first polarizer polarizes light in this direction, but because the second one is polarized, allows the light, which is perpendicularly polarized, to be transmitted, that it is absorbed. So this is this state, when it is dark, is all cross-polarizing. And then, if you have, if you have general direction, then you see something. The idea with this one was, if you look at this, I hope that it will not fall apart again. Yeah, it is. But anyhow, look now, find the position where you don't see the smiley. Can you find the orientation of your polarizer when you don't see the smiley here on the screen? Okay. Now, here we are.
You got the graphics, right? I gave you the
meter. In front of you, you have a... sorry. In front of you, you have mineral called quartzite. Have you ever seen it? Yes or no? No? Calcite. Could you try read the text through the calcite? What do you see? What do you observe? If you try to read through the calcite. How many images do you see? Maybe do you see something special? You have to answer to my question. It's not interesting just to stand here and asking questions.
She is a boring teacher. She will not leave you to go further if you don't answer.
You have to say something. Did you try? Yes. Okay. You have seen double letters, right? Why do you think that happened? Why do you think that you observe double letters? Is there something special, some special property of the light of the material? Could you please answer? Oh, correct answer. You have read, right? Yeah, I know, I believe that you do. But could you please make another experiment? Take a polarizing foil and rotate it in front of the calcite. You still have a mineral on the deck. You see the double image and then rotate the polarizing foil in front of it. What happened? What do you see? What do you observe?
A certain angle that just becomes a single image.
Yeah.
Is this like when water bends the shape of a straw?
What do you think about that?
I'm asking you.
What did she ask?
Yeah, this is like when water, when you have a straw in water, it looks like it bends the direction of the straw. That's why, right? It shifts the words over.
Koliko da bi slanca u pognuću biraš po nogu.
Reći
ne. No, you're wrong.
Okay. You also got a small box. Yeah? You can find the liquid crystalline cell in it. Do you see the small white box? Yes. Yeah, they are on the table. You can. You have maybe two or three liquid crystalline cells in it.
So
You have to take a laser, and direct the beam through the liquid crystal itself. And observe the... very small wet cell, like this. Maya will give you. Very small, centimeter long wet cell.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is. You have to find the area where the beam splits into two beams.
Okay, there, two beams.
My beam.
Already, you guys from the tables, you don't have, come closer.
Go closer.
Or look up.
Look up.
Or look up. What they will do, they are shining through the wedge cell filled with liquid crystal. And then they put polarizer on it, and then they rotate the polarizer.
Okay. Now I've done the same experiment as you. There is, the light is coming through the wet cell. It's similar to the rainbow. The rainbow is made by the prism because the refraction indices depend on the color. It has different directions after passing the prism. This is the same. Two polarizations have different refraction indexes, that's why they split to two. And now let us check something else. Let us check their polarization. If the polarizer is perpendicular to the polarization of the light, then the part, the beam that is polarized in the perpendicular direction will extinguish. What does it mean now? Okay. Yeah, okay. Now try this.
Then the lower part
his forehead is wrapped in the direction which is perpendicular to it. What happens? There are scratches on the glass, and elevated molecules orient along these scratches. They somehow sit in the valleys of scratches. And then they make such a structure within the cell. So they rotate like this. What happens? If the light enters this, the first polarizer polarizes the light, then the polarization follows the structure, and then here the light is emitted. So this bright part is actually the switch on, the state without any voltage on the screen. But when we apply voltage, the following happens. So look at this. Here is a part, here is some, this is a copper. This is simply a copper model for a molecule, or as for a liquid crystalline molecule. If I rub this, you know that materials, when they are rubbed, they become charged. And if they are charged, there is an electric field. So this is not charged, but this is it.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
So, whenever you approach to something that is not charged with some electric field, it tries to orient in the direction of the electric field, which is exactly what happens with liquid crystals. When the voltage is applied on the cell, liquid crystals, the molecules, try to orient along the electric field. So, when you have the completely switch-on state, the light doesn't see the structure anymore. Here it enters the cell, and here it is absorbed. And this means dark state. When you have something in between, this is, let's say, half of the light is transmitted, not more. So we made a model of the pixel. It is a simple thing. There is a, you have two contacts, there is a liquid crystal in between, and then if you apply the voltage, what happens? Here is this cell. If you watch closely, you see, now it's closed. So if you want to make your screen that it is energetically favorable, it has to be white. When you need a dark state, you have to apply the voltage and you need more energy, not less. But of course, with the illumination that is done by the light source, you can also make less illuminated background. This is a different story. But simply making the background dark doesn't make spending less energy. So now we actually understand the structure of the pixel. And we have some slight idea how it is working. And now we have something else. I would like to show you a few pictures. I'm a theoretical physicist, so I do similar work as theoretical physicists do here. So we have experimental results and we try to explain that. And I would like to explain you why do we love liquid crystals. They have potential for applications. There are many new applications that come to liquid crystals. I can't talk about them now because we don't have time. There are materials, new materials, that are synthesized every day. They have really peculiar properties, very interesting phenomena and so on. And for every scientist is always the motivation, why is that so? Why this is something like happening? But let us go to the picture gallery and let us see some pictures. So these are pictures that were taken in our lab. So this is a simple liquid crystal made by Irnea with our students that is observed under the cross polarizers under the microscope. Here we tried to order this material, so we wrapped something. It was practically a similar procedure, but on the level of the school for ordering liquid crystals like they do it in liquid crystal display. Then these are some stolen pictures, or maybe borrowed pictures, if you like. This is a picture of an interesting labyrinth that appeared in some liquid crystalline film that was made by a colleague of mine, Eva Goretzka. So there was a drop of the liquid crystal, which during the few hours developed something like this. So, well, that was a peculiar question. Why is it so? And it's the same stuff from the same film observed by some equipment. And now, I give the word to Maya, because we have some fun experiments for you to do.
I will be very quick because we don't have time, but if you have your polarizer in your hand, I believe we have done that much that you can share a little bit. Try to put it in this direction, that your screen here, the screen will be
black.
So you have to find a direction so the screen is black.
This
screen now. Big one, the middle one. I heard many times that there is no small things in America. Yeah, so you did it? You are looking it? So if I put some very common plastic, oh, we all know it's a CD case, okay, no, not that much in use as it was before. But if I put it here, so what can you see? Those are funny experiments. So more for the wow effect. Yeah, or maybe if you have some other plastic, or all you know, you see those knives or other things. If you observe, you can rotate the polarizer so you can observe what happens if you rotate the polarizers.
Can you bend the fork?
I can bend the fork. I bend like this. Okay, I can, but I'm not strong enough. Yeah, I can do it like this. Yeah, I know what you mean. Many those plastics are all anisotropic, so the light passes through because of other properties of it. The light, its color. Please.
At home, you can use saran wrap.
What?
Saran wrap. They know what it is. Plastic wrap, and you can stretch it.
Yeah.
And you'll see the patterns of the saran wrap.
But this is the homework.
But they need to know what's.
So, I can repeat the homework. Yeah, there is some homework to do.
There is some homework for you, so.
Yeah, the plastic thing, so if you have some plastic that you can stretch, try to stretch it in between to cross polarizer. If you have the screen, so the first time it's polarized, so you will see that the polymers inside of the in the fold will get more ordered and the color will change. Or, okay, you will see what happened and also the thickness change. But if you observe this picture here, I have a picture here, again with the polarizer, huh? Yeah. And then you rotate it. What happened? I will put it more up. So, oh, wow, okay.
Oh, it's like a human face.
Aha, it's a human face.
Yeah.
And
then turned into like a bird.
You have to tell me which bird. No, I
don't. Almost as human as you are.
Huh?
A bird almost as pretty as you.
Tell again, I want to hear it three times. yeah, so maybe you are interested how to make these things. Many artists, so there are some artists using this type of pictures. Here we have a laser. Great, you can also put it there. Yeah, okay. So how to make this picture? Any ideas?
No.
No? You don't have any idea. It's very simple. I will just show it how, so you can play at home and you can do your homework. We will check it for sure. So if you have, if you can use your screen for the polarized light, and then if you have some glass, because glass is try to look now the screen through the glass, so it changed somehow. Anyhow, no, why? Any ideas?
It's isotropic.
You will see that also your polarizers are on the glass. So, so we have to put in between two cross polarizers some anisotropic material. We can do it with liquid crystal, but you don't have that home, I suppose. But we can use some other material. You saw before that we have a lot of plastic material that is anisotropic, or most of it. That it's transparent, so the light are passing through. So my assistants here are making an even better picture than before. And they're using a very non-usual material that you for sure never saw.
Okay.
Yeah. Should be transparent. Don't use the black one or the silver one. So now observe the artwork of our colleagues. The challenge is making it even more beautiful at home. So, yeah, it's Scotch tape, it's anisotropic, they're making it with, so they stretch it, please.
But why the pattern? Is it just different sections or?
Yeah, they put it more sections, more layers in different directions, so direction
okay, so
is something, the thickness, yeah, so I have to end. Homework again. Okay, it was a joke for the homework, but there are really quite a lot of experience you can do at home, and we can be then aware of this phenomena that it is with anisotropic materials, because those stuff is really everywhere around us. So these are us. Moitz already told that we are five. The question is, how many persons are here on the picture?
Three.
Back again to mathematics.
Why? Five. Four? No, there are five.
On the picture.
Seven.
Five.
You're cheating.
Six.
There are seven. That's why we are not here in three.
Hey, this guy on the side is really...
We have proofs that there are seven.
I have to tell something else. This picture is 2 weeks old. When Yanea and Sasha defended their PhDs.
Okay, so this will be it for our from us, so thank you very much. Are there any questions? What's up for us?
Yes.
Just go ahead.
Yeah. Besides the artwork, is there any benefits that we can do here to enhance education and also to enhance possibly stimuli for health?
For health?
For health.
Yeah. So, well, first thing is polarized glasses.
Okay.
So, if you observe the light which is reflected is polarized. So whenever you go on the water or for skiing, there is a lot of reflection that damage the eyes, because the eyes are, actually there is intensity of light is too high. So that's why you have polarized glasses that absorbs only the reflected light, but not the direct light. This is the reason, this is one of the reasons. Then, okay, polarizers like this, they are more for fun. But for education, there are many really nice projects to do with them. So you can ask children or students to find out how is with the color when you give some material in between. So let's say as a light source you use the screen, and as one polarizer is used for checking the state of polarization, checking the state of the colors and such things. So there are many projects you can do with kids in this sense. There is another question. You'll get your answer. There's another question here. Yeah. Oh, okay, Randy.
Do the cars, fancy cars, have the automatic dimmers on your rearview mirror? That's this technology too, right? Of course, you wear polarized sunglasses at night.
I'm sorry, I'm not sure that I understood. What?
There are cars that have, so you know, there's the rearview mirror.
Yeah.
The car, and then there's a car behind you and it has lights on.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, these night mirrors.
Yeah. I think like on the rear windows, cars have polarized, because if you wear a polarized sunglasses, you can see them.
There are many applications that deal with really the reflected light.
Yeah, but my follow-up question for him, like if you want to like just play around with this at home, what's the cheapest clear polarizer that you can get? Not a sunglass, not a fishing
glass. The cheapest clear polarizer you can get. Yeah, we have some of them.
Okay.
Yeah. What?
Oh, okay.
Okay, we have some pieces of polarizers for the guys that would like to have them. So, but in principle, I can't say the the cheapest. Well, one of the origins of polarizers is this. These are glasses for
3D movie.
So you can absorb me. You take the polarizer and you see something funny.
Yeah, I mean, sunglasses would do with their color. I'm looking for like what you did out there with the tape. Is that like if you put like enough material, would that become a polarizing material package in tape?
No, this is not a polarizing material. This is an isotropic material. So to see these special properties, you need polarizer, one polarizer, and the polarized light source, which is every screen. So, yeah. Any other questions?
Isn't there like some really rubbery? What's the rubbery effect? Is it actuator effect?
Rubber effect. So the glass has to be rubbed in order that you get from scratches the holes in the glass. And then because molecules are elongated, they like to stick to the glass. And because they like to stick to the glass, they arrange inside of the holes. So you simply wrap the glass with the welder. It can be done even for simple things. You take the object glass for microscoping and you can do it by welder and it will work. So when you wrap this, the molecules orient along this rubbing direction and it is really done in the factories. So they have clean rooms because there shouldn't be any dust and everything. And they have such big pieces of glass and such big cylinders which rotate, and they have melatonin that they really rub glasses in a sense.
Is it velvet or is it sandpaper or what?
No, there is velvet. It has to be very tiny.
So the chirality is introduced by actually bending the two plates?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, it's not
well,
okay.
It could go in either direction, from this to this or from this to this. That's why they add some chiral doping, so that they prohibit this degeneration of the space.
Oh, but that means it's fixed. It's not that they are bending the two materials, right? Force the molecules or the...
They force the molecules to make this structure.
Oh, so they're actually bending it, they're applying physical force.
Yeah, exactly. With these rubbing directions, they force molecules to follow this path.
And why do they decide? I mean, it could have been simpler to have one polarizer and have a linear anisotropic material, right? And just have it switch to produce dark and white spots. Why do they have this complex chiral?
Because they want to have gray levels. So you can switch it from one to another, but when they have this, let's say, the light follows like this, so it transmits the light goes through. But when you apply the force, when you apply the liquid field, the molecules in between turn a little bit up, more or less. And then it affects the light that is transmitted more or less. So you have gray levels. And gray levels are very important because you go from that 0 to 255 from the very next reading. Any other?
Okay, there are no more questions? Last question.
I'm curious as this application can be used for security purposes, identification of security.
Randy, can you help this?
Okay,
security.
Security. There are so many applications nowadays that have liquid crystals lasers can be made from liquid crystals where the light, the frequency, the wavelength of light can be manipulated continuously. Then there are optical switches, so you can have a wire from the liquid crystal. And with this, you know, if you have optical fiber, the fiber is fiber. If you want to allow for the fiber to leak, you have to bend it. But this is not practical. You can't do anything with bending. Have it somewhere, oh, bend now and then make a connection. But with liquid crystals, you rarely end the liquid crystal inside and two fibers can communicate. So then you have materials. Then they can control the moisture. So you put the liquid crystal, it changes color if the moisture was too high. Or if the temperature was too high, it changes the state that remains the same. So they develop some things that they put it when they transport tuna from Australia to Japan. So in order that they know that the level of the temperature was all the time below some certain level. And so there are so many, but
privacy.
Security.
Privacy windows. So you can make, films, and then you switch them on and you can see through them.
Yeah.
And you switch it off and it becomes opaque.
Instead of darkness.
We have to stop. We have to stop. I promised the owner.